Anya Babbitt gets to keep her company. Mostly. Following 9 months of negotiations, she and her board agreed last week to sell her startup Splitting Fares Inc., doing business as SPLT, to German automotive conglomerate Robert Bosch GmbH, with the caveat that the Detroit-based corporate ride-sharing software firm be an independent subsidiary. This means Babbitt and her team remain in place to lead and expand the startup, while Bosch's leadership operates more as an advisory and investment partner than an owner. They understand that why SPLT is successful is not the technology, it's the people, Babbitt said. The accelerated rise of new technologies and the changing consumer landscape around automotive, driven by mobility, autonomous driving, connectivity and electrification, has shifted the legacy industry's approach to acquisitions. Southeast Michigan's largest industry is now more like California's tech sector, pushing for higher risk, low-value deals with long-term potential instead of near-term profits. We want to be very careful to not destroy anything we buy, said René Schlegel, president of Bosch's Mexico operations, Robert Bosch S. DRL DCV, and a member of SPLT's board. When it comes to startups, it's about talent. We're keeping them independent because we want to keep its strength while we build the company going forward. It's important for the continuity of the acquisition for the people that started the company, that made it strong, to remain with it. Not because we see it as a trend, but because that's what makes it successful. Glenn Stevens, executive director of Detroit-based auto industry marketing organization Machito, said Bosch's approach to SPLT is becoming the new normal and representative of the paradigm shift in the industry's approach to new bets on technologies. This is just another example of the auto industry and the tech industry converging, no, colliding, Stevens said. The tech industry is traditionally more used to operating in partnerships, and these two industries are learning from each other and adapting their business models in different, but similar ways. The approach is different because its acquisitions are different. Legacy Automotive traditionally engaged in M&A activity that immediately impacted its bottom line, acquiring a competitor, a plant, for example, and led to an immediate vertical integration and takeover of the acquired assets, corporate governance, balance sheet and operational fortitude. But software acquisitions aren't bolt-on entities designed to be rolled out through the chain of operations, said Mike Wall, director of automotive analysis for research firm IHS Markit in Southfield. We're all living in the near-term pressure of selling cars, but acquisitions like this are a different value proposition, Wall said. They are investing in these entities and these people, not in a parts plant. These are standalone investments, where they are dedicating capital, letting it gestate and see what comes out of it, and not wanting to disrupt what made these companies successful.